Hey everybody, welcome back to Luther in Magdeburg Part 2. Thank you for watching Part 1. And in this video, I want to talk about primarily two things. One, the service that Anthony and I went to, which was in the dome. What was that service about? And what happened after with the pipe organ and the drone? And then secondly, I want to talk about outreach. How do you do outreach in a land full of atheists? Stay tuned. So I don't know if you know this, Germany has 16 states. Magdeburg is in the state of Saxony-Anhalt, and as a statistic of 2011, there's about 2.2 million people in this region. So as Anthony and I walked away from the dome service that morning, of course we had a discussion, and our hearts broke once again for those who are stuck in religion, who just go through a liturgy of a certain prayer, a certain creed, the Lord's Prayer, hearing a message for about 10 minutes about a Bible story that was not exposited correctly, didn't give hope, did not give the gospel. This breaks our heart. And so for the atheist who would come from the region to a service like that, they would be totally lost. They wouldn't have a clue. They would think, what planet are these people in this building from? So that leads us to the answer or the question, what is outreach? In Acts chapter 1:8, it says, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, and Samaria. And it's with that Bible verse, I really respect and commend Anthony Fisher for how he is doing his outreach. He does this little home thing, which I'm going to tell you about. Then he does this little city thing with a greater influence. And then he's part of this greater, bigger movement. It's phenomenal. So let's start with Anthony's little Jerusalem, where he lives, the six-story building. So what does he do? He goes and he invites his neighbors in his building to come for a dinner. There's no cost, come as you will, have a great time. We're promoting this American, crazy American chef. And so we make three dishes. Here's a couple videos about that and even some culinary tips. We are here tonight putting a dinner on, a buffet for about 20 people to make friendships, to build a bridge of relationship with people in this building where Tony lives. And so tonight we're having three dishes. We're having a red sauce, a meat red sauce with pasta, and then a chicken Alfredo. It's almost like a chicken primavera. And then we're going to have a vegetarian dish and a great salad. And for this chicken dish, it's chicken tenderloin in a cream sauce. Vegetables are underneath here. They were already cooked. And so you take this wonderful chicken cream sauce and put half of it in here, like so. You mix this pasta, vegetable, and then we'll take some cheese, put au gratin on top, and it's ready to go. Bon appetit.
It's perfect, amazing.
But that's the point. It's about building the bridge of relationship, trust. You know, Anthony's a little bit different than the average atheist. They notice that, they question it. And it's amazing what God does on that bridge of relationship. Ultimately, hopefully, by the grace of God, and as we pray, Anthony will have the opportunity to share the gospel with these people. So then just expanding a little bit further for him, his Judea would be something a little bit broader, and that's called Church Goes Pub. Phenomenal concept. I don't want to waste your time going into all the details, but basically this organization goes to different various restaurants or speaking halls once a month, and they do music. They have a guest speaker share their testimony, which Anthony did. And it's phenomenal. It's a great concept where the church goes to the people, not the church waits for the people to come into their doors. So we have Jerusalem, Judea, and now Samaria. So
It's a phenomenal story, but there's an organization that would like to get the gospel to all 80 million Germans. And how they do that is, for example, on a Saturday, Anthony and I went to a church, we stuffed these newspapers, and the cover story was Nick Vukacek, I don't know if I say that right, without no limbs, Nick. And we stuffed this newspaper, we took this newspaper to several homes in the area for them to read about life transformation, stories of people who were lost, who are now found, and it's a phenomenal movement in Germany. I really respect that.
So since it's the season of Martin Luther, the question should be asked, what if Martin Luther was resurrected from the dead and came to Magdeburg? How would he do outreach? What would his message be? Well, that's a very good question. I don't really know the answer to it. All I know is that in this day and age, in the 21st century, 2017, we have to be creative, tenacious, intentional, build relationships, and do our follow-up. So let me tell you about the drone in the dome story. It was phenomenal. I'll let Anthony tell you the rest of the story.
Of course, we wanted to abide by the rules, so we thought we need to get a permission to do this. And there was a sign saying, hey, you can buy a photo video permission for €2. And here it is. It didn't say you're not allowed to use a drone. So we just bought this for €2 and had fun.
So that's basically the story. I don't want to put that video inside of this video, so it's going to be a standalone video. I want to tell you about what happened after the service on that Sunday in the Dome. I was thinking during the service, in honor of the Reformation and in honor of this great song, A Mighty Fortress Is Our God, I asked God, could I play the organ here in the Dome in honor of the great theology of that song? So I waited and the service was over. Then I found out the guy's name, who's the organist, Barry Jordan. And then I stood by the door. He came down. I introduced myself. I said, it's probably going to be an impossible question. And he said, well, why don't you come back in about an hour? So he came. We met at 1 hour later and he took me in the door with Anthony in an elevator up to the 6th floor. I mean, it was ginormous. Great, I'm going to keep my word. It's only one verse.
Oh, you can play another one if you like.
Okay, good. Thanks. So wasn't that awesome? What a great privilege and honor that I had. And so to God be the glory. So I don't want to take up all your time on this video with that song and the second song I played, which was In Christ Alone. So that's going to be a standalone video. So everybody, thank you for tuning in to Luther in Magdeburg. I'm grateful for your time, and I hope that it was informative. Thank you for praying for me. Thank you for your financial partnership. And until next time, auf Wiedersehen.